that's when the enemies of Allah then threw him with stones, and some of the stones started hitting the forehead of Imam Al-Hussain alayhi salam, shedding his blood. He took the blood and he covered his face with it, and he said, "Hakadha alqa Allah mukhadhaban bidami." This is how I'm gonna face my Lord, covered in my blood. And I will tell my grandfather, Rasulullah, this is what this nation did to me. Until he was sitting down, wiping his face from the blood. One enemy of Allah shoots him with an arrow that has three heads. It pierces the heart of Imam Al-Hussein. He then cries, Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati Rasulillah. He takes the blood, the arrow out of his back. With it comes out his liver, and his body is now covered in blood. The women, the children, they see him. They start crying, Aywa Husayna. The horse then of Imam Al-Hussein comes and covers its face with the blood of Imam Al-Hussein, rushes back to the tent. When the women hear the horse, some of them thought Imam Al-Hussein is coming back. As they come out, they saw the horse covered in blood, and there is no rider on the horse. They started crying, Aywa Imama, Aywa Husayna. Aywa Sayyida. Zainab alayhi salam rushes to the body of Abi Abdullah. She stands next to him crying, Akhi Hussein, brother Abu Abdullah. Imam Al-Hussein looks at her and says, Zainab, go back to the tent. Take care of my women and children, ya Zainab. Khuya ana b'aini labari lak iyalak. أنا بروحي لخلي لك أطفالك خويا يا نور العين يا ريت الموت يرضاني بدالك. She says, I will do so. Then she turns to Umar ibn Sa'd. She said, يا ابن سعد أيقتل الحسين وأنت تنظر إليه. Oh, son of Ibn Sa'd, Hussein is getting killed in front of your eyes and you're standing there doing nothing about it. He then cries, the pain, his conscience is killing him. He turns to the enemies and says, get up and finish him, kill him. Arihu. Then Zainab goes back to the tent. One of the children of Imam al-Hasan by the name of Abdullah, he runs out of the tent. He was about 11 years old. He throws himself on the body of Imam al-Hussein, covered with arrows, spears, and says, Ya Am, Aywa Amma, Aywa Husayna. While he was crying, an enemy comes to him. He sees the enemy. The boy, Abdullah, tells the enemy, leave my uncle alone, O enemy of Allah. That enemy strikes him with a sword. It cuts off his hand. The boy looks at his uncle, Imam al-Hussein, says, uncle, they cut off my arm. Imam al-Hussein cries and says, son, be patient, be patient. And then they shoot the boy with an arrow that kills him on the chest of Imam al-Hussein. One of the enemies of Allah says, I came to kill Imam al-Hussein. I looked at him covered in blood. I swear by Allah, I've never seen a man covered so much in blood, yet his face is shining with beauty, with brightness. I got scared of killing Imam al-Hussein and ran away. Then came Shimr ibn al-Jawshan, la'natullahi alayh, to the body of Imam al-Hussein, lying there on the plains of Karbala. Imam al-Hussein turns to Allah in his final moment. He prays to Allah, Allahumma muta'ali al-makan, azim al-jabarut. Oh Allah, You are in your greatness and your highness. Oh Allah, I turn to you at the time of my distress and the time of my need. Oh Allah, help me. Oh Allah, look after me. Oh Allah, look after my women and my children. Shimr comes to him. He kicks the body of Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. He then sits on the chest of Imam al-Hussein. He then holds on to the head of Imam al-Hussein, takes his sword and severs the head of Imam al-Hussein. Aywa Imama! Aywa Husayna! Aywa Shayida! Aya! Shi'ati! Mahma raitu min shayidin fadhkurun. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.